Dear professional friends, today I am going to discuss an interesting case on a reactivation of disqualified company directors DIN. DIN of disqualified directors can be reactivated to avail the benefit of the Central Mentors Fresh Start Scheme 2020, says Kerala High Court. Recently, Delhi High Court ordered the reactivation of DINs and DSAs of the disqualified directors within a period of 3 working days in the case of Sandeep Agarwal versus Union of India, mainly to take the benefit of the CFSS 2020 scheme. Likewise, the same policy as applied by the Kerala High Court in Thirunavukkarasu Raghunathan versus Union of India and others. Kerala High Court ordered in this case to restore the DIN of the directors to take benefit of the CFSS 2020 scheme. The court is of the firm opinion that in order for the CFSS scheme to be active, directors of the companies ought to be given an opportunity to avail the scheme. On September 28, 2020, Monday, the Kerala High Court directed the Registrar of Companies Kerala to reactivate the cancelled director identification number DIN and digital signature certificate to disqualified directors whose DINs were cancelled on account of failure to furnish prescribed returns. Agreed that the disqualification and the cancelled DINs prevented them from availing the central government's Fresh Start Scheme 2020 for the companies to file their returns and regularize their operation, they approached the High Court. Along this, their prayer, Justice N. Nagaresh found, since their disqualification did not affect the petitioners or a single company alone, but it would extend to any other company in which they were directors, the court opined that their DIN should be activated. Further, the scheme would be rendered nugatory if the DINs were not reactivated, since it was envisaged for the companies such as the one involved in the litigation, the judge remarked. Under the such circumstances, qualify the directors permanently and not allowing them to avail the DINs and the DSEs could render the scheme nugatory. The scheme notified in March 2020 allows companies who have defaulted in filing prescribed financial statements and annual returns to duly file them without incurring penalties or charges. The litigation before the High Court was instituted after two directors were unable to avail the scheme 2020 by reason of the DINs and DSEs being cancelled. The cancellation was on account of the failure to furnish the returns pertaining to financial years after 2014. As per Section 164 of the Companies Act was notified, the directors were disqualified. Section 164 describes the condition under which a director would be deemed disqualified for the purpose of the legislation. Failing to file returns is one of the disqualifications listed in the section. The directors submitted that they were unable to furnish the returns for one of the companies after 2014 because it was a Sikh company. Therefore, much of the assets had been taken over the banks or had been sold, making it impossible for the directors to ascertain the exact position of the company to file the returns. Apart from the advocates now avowed the petitioners were entitled to avail the scheme given that their company did not fall under any of the categories barred by the center's scheme. On the other hand, Central Government Council argued that the state had no issues with the petitioners applying for the scheme, but the scheme could not be a reason to reactivate the DIN numbers and of the petitioners. There was an additional concern raised pertaining to the lapse time between the failure to file returns and the litigation in the court. Rejecting the center's submission, Justice Nagaresh found that a fresh cause of action was initiated with the announcement of the Fresh Start Scheme 2020. The launch of the scheme itself constitutes a fresh and continuing cause of action, and therefore question of delay of limit or limitation should not arise, the court said. Therefore, the respondents were directed to reactivate the DINs and digital signatures and allow the petitioners to benefit the Fresh Start Scheme 2020 if they were otherwise eligible. With this, the petition was disposed of. What we learned from this, it was argued that the lapsed time between the failure to file the returns from 2014 onwards and the litigation of the court, there was a lapse of time. However, the court answered that the launch of scheme itself constitutes a fresh and continuing cause of action, and therefore the question of delay or limitation should not arise, the court said. To disqualify directors permanently and not allowing them to avail their DINs and DSEs could render the CFSS scheme 2020 announced by the central government as nugatory. It is submitted that ROC offices across India makes a condition that if a new director is to be appointed from back end, then the company should not have been stricken off. However, Delhi and the High Court, Kerala High Court are not agreeing to this and asked the ROC to reactivate DINs of the directors and the company which has not filed its returns and had been stricken off. Thus, the stricken off companies should be given an opportunity to have avail the Fresh Start Scheme 2020 by appointing a new director from the background from all the ROCs of the across India, mainly to file all such pending forms by availing the benefit of CFSS 2020 scheme. I request the MCA to issue such a circular to facilitate this, because all ROCs are asking that the company should not have been stricken off for appointing a back-end director. Friends, if you like this video, I request you to please subscribe my channel. Thanking you once again, R.V. Shekhar, Practicing Company Secretary.